Point of order, Sir Ian Duncan Smith.
Mr. Deputy Speaker, I rise on a point of order literally as an email from the Speaker has arrived in our offices. The key issue here is that I understand that Mr. Speaker has been contacted by MI5 and is now warning members of Parliament that there has been an agent of the Chinese government active here in Parliament working with a member of Parliament, obviously to subvert the processes here. I say, as a member of Parliament who is sanctioned by the Chinese government, as others, that this is a matter of grave concern, and I therefore rise on three points which are really important. Number one, will this now lead to a serious overhaul of the accreditation procedures here in the House of Commons? Because it's clearly too slack that these people get in, either in APPGs or with individuals. Is it possible that we will have a statement from the Speaker, from the Chair, about the risks? I am one of those who has done a lot to try and help fleeing Hong Kong Chinese, fleeing the communist regime here in the UK. We have names and numbers of people, and that leaves me worrying that some of these have been accessed by such an individual. These would be their lives and their families at risk, and I am deeply concerned about this because my activities, therefore, may well have been traced as those as well from my colleagues and friends. And I understand that the latest news that I hear is that this individual is not to be deported and no further action to be taken. How can it be, Mr. Deputy Speaker, that an agent of a foreign despotic and despicable power that is hell-bent on reducing many of those people into penury, it seems, how can they put somebody into Parliament, this mother of parliaments, and then that individual have nothing done to them other than they're not allowed in Parliament? This is surely not good enough. And could there be a statement from the government as to what they plan to do, and possibly, with respect, of course, from the Chair and Mr. Speaker?
I'd like to thank the Right Honourable Member for his point of order and giving me forward notice of it. As you know, it's not the policy of the Chair to comment in detail on any security matters, and I will certainly not be doing so today. As far as any statement either from the Chair or indeed from a Government Minister, I've been given no notification whatsoever that that is happening, but should that change, then I'm certain that members will be notified in the usual way. And as far as the third point, as I said, we don't discuss the detail of security issues on the floor. However, I can assure the Right Honourable Member that the House authorities are in regular contact with the appropriate government agencies on this matter, and we will update our advice and activities as necessary.